Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. I'm John Luke, the reselling white boy. Today I've got a different type of video for you all. So normally I'd do a sales update and a haul video once or twice a week. But today I think I've got 20 sales to pick. So I'm not gonna do just a video on that. I'm gonna show you a few of my sales. I'm gonna show you a little bit of packaging and how I package some of my items. Then I'm gonna take you on a little haul journey. So we're gonna go pick some stuff up that I won on eBay last night. Maybe pop in and do a little bit of RA. Yeah, just a little bit of a different video, just to mix it up a little bit before the car boots and the charity shops open. So yeah, if you enjoy the video, hit like, hit subscribe. I'm moving around, so it feels like we're on a boat again. But yeah, enjoy. A little bad habit of mine is I don't start my day until after 12 o'clock. I know it's a bad habit. Basically, I wake up about 10 o'clock and then I just chill out in the morning. Then I get moving just after 12. I think it's about 12:30 now. Really sunny outside. It's now Friday afternoon. So yeah, let's get into it. If you enjoy the video, hit like, hit subscribe. Just a big shout out as well. Down below, I've got my Amazon links down there now. So everything I use for my business is now down below. So any little bits and bobs that you might think that I use, that's everything down there. PVC walls have come for the shed. Just need to insulate the walls and then get them on tomorrow, which is Saturday. So yeah, got 12 of those big panels. So yeah, we've insulated most of the ceiling area. Did that yesterday and the day before. But yeah, I'll just spin this round and then see what's going on. Need to panel the wall with insulation. Got plenty of that here and then loads of little extra bits which are going to put on and in there and there. But yeah, we've got the new racks that are going to go up. Obviously, the PVC is going to go up on the ceiling and the walls. And then my dad's going to do a little graffiti. Might get the reselling white boy, blow that up somewhere. So yeah, as you can see, does his graffiti and stuff. That's just a little throw up. But yeah, he should be able to get some nice artwork. I'm just in here because I'm going to need to pick a couple of orders because I've started having a little bit of stock down here as the loft is just an absolute tip and I just really don't want to get on top of that. So yeah, what I'm going to do, I'm going to pick some of these little bits. So yeah, I'm just going to pick a couple of little orders and then shoot back up to the loft. We'll get things packaged and show you what else sold. But yeah, I just wanted to show you a little update on the shed as people have been asking. We've not really been talking about it recently. But yeah, awesome stuff. Nice big space, big enough for me. A nice window. We crack that open, it's going to get nice and warm in here, especially in the winter. It'd be nice to get a little heater in here. Going to get my brother's an electrician, so I'm going to get him to, obviously we've got a little bit of electrics in here, but what we're going to do is we're going to pump in a couple more little ports, then we'll get everything sorted really. Testing area, photographing area, packing area, and then loads of storage. Possibly do my streams from here. We'll see how the internet holds up. Obviously I use a wired ethernet up in my room, so yeah, it just depends how we get on. See if what the wireless is like down here. But yeah, if not, I might get a booster because it would be nice to have a nice backdrop for streams. Definitely film some videos in here. But yeah, awesome stuff. We have got a little gnome. All right, so we're up in the loft now. I'm going to pick some orders and then talk you through a couple. I'm not going to go through them all because it's not fully sales video. Just going to fly through the day, try and get things done a little bit faster because you know I leave everything a little bit too late. But I'm going to show you a little bit of the packaging that I use, how I package things and stuff like that. Some of the stuff's not that hard to package, but I'll just sort through a couple of examples of what I do when I'm shipping my items. Okay, so I've picked all my orders. Got a couple of pair of pants. I've got a women's zip-up, little game. A Batwoman figure, we have got a Wii bundle, a Ghost figure, plenty of them Power Ranger Ninja Stars that I've always spoken about, plenty of the Clippers, we've got an Imaginex bundle. Yeah, basically that's it. I think it's 17 or 18 orders in total. I'll pop up a few little bits on screen as and when I package stuff, and you know, you just see some of the sales that way instead of me taking quite a lot of time talking through each item. So yeah, that's everything from the last couple of days. So yeah, awesome stuff. I'm not sure on the total cost of everything, but yeah, it's not the 800 that I've been getting the last few weeks, but yeah, still a really good amount. With it being Friday, I've had pretty good sales this morning. The last couple of days have been a little bit dry, about 4 or 5 sales on each day. But yeah, Friday today, people are getting paid, and then the first of the month tomorrow, people are getting paid. So yeah, make sure you're listing, as people are getting that money coming in, looking to obviously get some stuff off eBay. All right, so the first thing I'm going to pack, nice and easy, it's this Lego Harry Potter game on the PlayStation 3. I think I got about £10 for this. With games, just use a D1 Jiffy bag by Mail Light. So buy a box of 100 of these on Amazon. I think they cost me about £12. So probably about 12p per unit. The links are in the description for those. But with these, I only use games that are pretty low value. Anything over really £10, Just got a little notification. Anything over £10, get into that £15 mark. I will send it in a box as a small parcel just to make sure it gets there for the buyer. But yeah, nice and easy. And I just write on it, everything I package, just write on it, Lego HP. And then I'll know what's in there. So when I go to print my label, I can easily find that and put it on. Next little bit, we've got the wall clippers. You've seen me sell tons of these. I was sending these in boxes at first, but then I trialed it with a mailing bag and they've been fine. Pretty robust packaging. So yeah, I'm just gonna use a mailing bag for this one. Some people might think that's a little bit underpacked, but with a low value item like this, I'm selling them as a multi-listing. I've literally not had a problem with the packaging yet. So I trust the courier to look after the item, and it saves me a hell of a lot of time. As there's one packed. So yeah, get a nice bag full of those. So these mailing bags are just a small size. I get these in a mixed mailing bag bundle. I got these off Amazon as well. So you get some larger ones and some smaller ones. But yeah, some things fit perfectly in these, which is cool, including these clippers. So I've done three now, got one left to do. Happy days. So yeah, that's 2 minutes done. We've got four clippers and a game packaged. So next up, we're gonna do some clothing, just to show you what I do to package my clothing. So I've just got this women's barber, half zip, quarter zip, size 12. So what I'll do, I'll just fold it up nicely, nice and easy. Ooh, getting a little bit of wind through the window. So we'll try and fold it as nice as we can. I actually have bought a clothes folder, but I've not used it yet. I'm gonna wait for the shed until I get using that proper, but I've folded that up and I've got these clear polythene bags. We just pop them in a bag like that. So yeah, popped it in a polythene bag, folded it up. I do have bigger ones of these. I possibly could have used a bigger one to get it a little bit more straight. But yeah, that does the job. And then this goes straight into a mailing bag. With my clothes, I like to use a purple mailing bag, if they fit anyway. Just find it makes it pop, makes it stand out a little bit. And it's just like a little psychological thing. When the buyer's buying clothing, they'll think, oh, nice mailing bag that. It's just one of those random little psychological things. If you get it in a nice purple mailing bag, you might think, oh, I might shop from there again. Might not make a difference, but yeah, I do like my purple mailing bags. Next up, we've got two pair of pants that I'm going to package. I'm not going to go through it, just the same process as before. So there's the white pair, there's the yellow pair. So we're going to put them together straight into a purple mailing bag. And away they go. So yeah, we've got pants, and then we've got barber. Nice and easy. So next we've got action figures, so stuff like Ghost, we have got Catwoman, stuff like that. How do I package these? So I'll box these up in bubble wrap, make sure they're all protected, because obviously I collect some stuff like this, so obviously you want to get them in a nice box, well packed, so you don't get any dinks and whatnot in the post. So all of my boxes, I get them from Tesco's, B&M, different places like that, whoever will, you know, give them, because they end up getting thrown away, recycled anyway, so you get some good use out of them. These ones get from my dad's work. My dad brings quite a lot of these home, and you just build these up and they're a really strong sturdy box. I think it's like a double wall. So yeah, I'll show you how these go. So yeah, you literally fold the walls in and build it like that way. This is actually inside out, so you can use either way. So yeah, what I'll do is I'll bubble wrap her, wrap some stuff around, make her look all neat so she can't really move. So there we have it, wrapped her in bubble wrap. I use a big roll from Amazon. And then these are just from my work. I work in a leisure centre slash arena. So they have different shows on. When the shows are finished, obviously they can't advertise it anymore. So I just use the pamphlets. I always pick loads up. I think I've got a big bag full down here. Big bag full down there. And yeah, just use them as packing paper. They're really strong, sturdy paper. So we pop that down and then she's not going anywhere. So I've just done exactly the same with Ghost. So on the outside, this is what the boxes look like. Really sturdy. So with the Ninja Stars, I've sold two bundles of 4 and 5 in the UK. And then a GSP buyer bought a bundle of 4 and 5 and a Series 3 also. So that works out really well. I think that's about £25. Obviously paid £2 each for these, so really good. I think the Series 3 I'm selling for about £12.49 each. And then a bundle of these for £14.49. Yeah, really cool. Going well. Obviously you see these in every video because they're just flying out. So yeah. Basically, I do exactly the same thing with these. I normally have a smaller type box and I don't wrap them as well because they're not really made to be kept in box. They get played with straight away. But yeah, I don't put them in a mailing bag, straight in a box. So yeah, popped series 345 in there, and then we've just labelled it so I know for later. And then these ones I'll just use a little bit of a smaller box, just for the 4 or 5 bundles. With this being with GSP, pretty strong box, hard wearing. So the last couple bits we've got to package is this Imaginex set, and then we've got the Wii bundle. I'll package all the Ninja Stars, all the figures and whatnot. Just got these to do, the big bulky items. So let's see how I pack these. Just a big tip as well, if you ever go to Primark, these bags are great for putting all your parcels in. You know, if you want like a Royal Mail sack type thing, and you have quite a few small parcels, really big bags of those. So yeah, I've got a really cool sized box that was from America, which I paid a customs fee for. It'll slot the Wii in nicely with the games and everything else. But yeah, pretty cool. So we wrap the console up very nicely. We'll slot that in. So yeah, then we've got some games, pretty much bundle fodder apart from Wii Sports. I did this as like a Motion Plus bundle just to get it moving a little bit faster. So yeah, makes it a little bit more appealing to the customer when there's a decent game in there. So I just put the games in polythene bag, and then I'm just gonna put a little layer of bubble wrap around it just to give it that little extra layer of protection. So there we have it, everything tucked in nicely, no budging in that. I might put a little bit of packing paper in, and then we'll get that going. There we have it, that's all packed up. I'll probably put my label over this side here instead of worrying about getting everything off. Got the customs charge sticker off just in case it confuses the courier. But yeah, well packed, happy days. So yeah, I forgot to mention I sold a black Wii controller with a silicone cover. So what I'll do with that, I'll just bubble wrap that and put that in a small box. And then this, we'll just talk through this one in a second before printing the labels and getting on the road. Okie dokie, so for the Imaginex, for the last parcel, we have got a big box from Tesco. We have actually cut the top off, but what I'm going to do, I will cut it down anyway and make sure there's some flaps over. So I think we won't need it this height anyway, probably around there. Might need to put a little bit of a top on it. But yeah, they come in handy, really sturdy boxes. I think they're double walled, triple walled, something like that. So yeah, happy days. And there we have it. Just made little roof for it. Smashed it. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to go downstairs, get all the labels printed, get gone. Go and drop these off, and then we'll go and pick up eBay orders, and then I might have a look in a few shops, see if we can pick anything up brand new. So this is the setup for labels at the minute. Obviously, I'm not in the shed yet, and it's boiling upstairs, so it's nice to just get out of there. Got some basic scales, which are 5 kg and below. And then, obviously, when I move in the shed, I'm going to get some proper industrial scales, which are really more accurate and better, really. So, yeah, I'm just going to get everything quickly labelled out and stuff, get them weighed. I'm using the Zebra GK420D. Awesome label printer. Links down below for that. But, yeah, would really recommend a label printer. I've only recently just got one the last month. But, yeah, it saves you so much time. Okay, so I'll just go on parcel to go up. Click eBay delivery up there. Once you go to eBay delivery, just comes up with all your orders. So then all your orders are up there. What you do then, you just put the weight and the size of the parcels and then choose what courier you are using. So I just use Hermes for all my big parcels. I'm going to be choosing to use UPS in the future. I'm going to make that switch very soon. Okie dokie, so I've just totaled up all the Hermes parcels, and we're just going to pay it, and then they'll just fly out of this machine, we'll whack them on the parcels, and off we go. I've just got the one Harry Potter game to do through Royal Mail. So this is like the adult version of being at the arcade. You've got all your tickets. So yeah, there's where we're currently sat. We've had a couple of slower days, like I said. Picked it a little bit up today. Might hopefully grow a little bit more. But yeah, we've had £4,751 worth of income in the 31-day period. Like the bloody graphs we see on the news every day. The weekend lag jumps up. So yeah, we need to keep the R down, the sales up. Well, I just messed up a little bit. Basically, I had 4 clippers going out because one woman cancelled. She just, I don't know, cancelled for some reason before I sent them. And then, basically, parcel to go still had that order in the basket. So I printed an extra label. So I might have to try and get a refund for that somehow. Might not be able to. But yeah, I messed up. I guess that's one of those things. I accepted the cancellation. So you'd think that parcel to go would just obviously take that off. But it's one of those things, a learning curve. But yeah, I'll see if I can chase that up anyway. Right, so I'm just about to set off now. I went on Facebook and I've just found a little original Xbox game bundle. Not the best of games, there's a couple of £7-8 games in there, but there's 28 games for a tenner, so literally just about 35p a game. So yeah, I'm going to go get that as well. We've got the wrestlers to pick up. I'll probably pop these up now so you can see. Got a big wrestling bundle and a toys bundle off the same seller on eBay. The wrestlers cost me £50 and the toys cost me 99p, so £51 all in from that. There's 150 wrestling figures and some extras and stuff. I put a bid in for some Sylvanian families the other day, £12.80 on eBay, and that's just ended, so I've got that as well. So I might pick that up this weekend. I don't fancy driving about all over the show. But yeah, happy days. Going to set off now and get going. All right, so it's boiling hot in the car, but I've just picked up 150 wrestlers. They cost me £50, and then there's some Imaginext toys and some other little bits that were £1 off the same buyer, off the same seller, so happy days. I've dropped the parcels off. So we're getting productive. It's now quarter to four, my clock's wrong on the car. But yeah, I'm going to pick up the Xbox games and then get home, and then I'll just show you a few bits and bobs from the pickups and then start editing the video that should be out tonight, Friday night. So yeah. All right, so the second pickup's about half an hour away, but she wants cash. She's actually got Sims 2 and loads of expansion packs. She's going to include them for a fiver, so I need £15 out. There's no cash machines anywhere, so I'm going to pop in now to get cash back, get some. And then there's a drive through Costa here, so I'll get a coffee as well while I'm at it. So I've got the cash out in Aldi. Got some Raiders or whatever. We got a cold ice caramel coffee thing. Happy days. And then we're going to head over to wherever we're going, about 25 minute drive, pick up that, and then we can get home and unbox it all. Got a pretty nice Costa view. It's like a pretty new industrial estate, I think. So that's like Aldi HQ or something, where all the sorting is. And then I went in the Aldi store just around the corner, which is also huge. Okay, second pickup done. So we got a ton of Sims 2 expansion packs and a ton of original Xbox games. They cost me £15 for the lot. So we'll go through them when I get home. There's a couple decent games, and these expansion packs, some are worth more than others, so I'll have to have a good look through them. And we're back. We're in the shed. We have picked everything up, so we're going to talk through what we've got. So loads of figures, loads of wrestling figures, got a bit of Imaginext and that games pickup, so we'll see what we can get through. This games bundle, Xbox Original and Sims 2 expansion packs. This cost me all in £15. So realistically about 30p a game, possibly not. I know there's 28 games, and then there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So there's 38 in total, 38 different discs. So I just separated the Xbox original games that are worth selling on their own. So we've got Fireblade, Spy vs. Spy, we've got GTA San Andreas, Rogue Trooper and Doom 3. To be honest, I've got an Xbox original collection going, so I might keep a few of these. GTA's got its maps in really nice condition. And then most of these are pretty much bundle worthy games, but if I don't have any in my collection, I will be keeping. So yeah, that's just to really fund my collection. Obviously, I'll make money on the bundle. These will be worth £15 alone. There's a couple of these at about £5 to £6. Some are like £3 to £4. But I might get a couple of bundles and I'll be able to get £20 to £30 for those. And then, yeah, straight profit. We'll sell some of the Xbox games. Might be a big bundle, keep a few, and then build on the collection. So yeah, I won a wrestler's bundle for £50 and a toy bundle for 99p from the same seller. So this is the Imaginext Batcave. I've actually got another one down there, which is a little bit different. That's like purple. It's a little bit of a different design. Maybe it's the same. Might just be a little bit incomplete, that one down there. But we've got the Monsters, Inc. Scare Floor, which is pretty cool. And then we've got this tub of toys, maybe a few Imaginext figures, and then just some random toys. So what we're going to do, I've not opened this yet. There's the wrestlers, 150 wrestlers. We're going to dig into this. She said it's not all connected to this. They're just random bits and bobs. So it might be rubbish, but let's go on an adventure. So we've got another tub to keep, which is good. Right, let's see what we've got. We have got a dopey or whatever he's called. He's naked. We've got some random little figures. What are those? 2013 Marvel. Little random figures. We have got, I think that's an Imaginext. Hasbro Marvel, maybe. 2007, that one. I'm not sure if it is Imaginext. Random figures. Got Uzma Kappa. Loads of these little Marvel figures. If anyone knows which ones these are from, let me know. just little plastic ones, nothing special. So we got like a little, maybe an Imagine X one there. Got another one of them dudes. Is that PJ Masks or something like that? A little Spider-Man, Iron Man. Got this little lady. We have got a, is that like a Disney Infinity one? No, it's not, is it? I'm not sure. Yeah, pretty cool. We've got a Power Ranger Imagine X. A few little more Imagine X, another PJ Mask dude. Another few of them figures. But yeah, it's all random stuff in here. Obviously, this was 99p with the Imagine X buildings. But yeah, I'm just going to dig through this, see what I can sell, really. But yeah, some cool stuff. Some cool stuff indeed. Yeah, if anyone recognises anything out of here and they know what it's from, because this is some random stuff. What's that? Wild West. Sheriff Collie's Wild West. That's a pretty cool dude. So, this bundle cost me £50. Let me just put it on a wide angle. If anyone spots anything of any value, let me know. If anyone spots anything that you need for your collection, let me know. So, yeah, there's another one of the broken handers. But, yeah, and that's, he's called Seamus, pretty sure. We have got a checkbook, Big Show checkbook. By the looks of it, Flip Madness Gold Edition. Not sure about anything about that. There's like a little rubbery one. But yeah, loads and loads and loads of stuff. Try and get deep into it. What have we got? Got this gold dude. So yeah, I'm going to end the video here. What I'm going to do now, I'm going to go and edit my video from yesterday. Hopefully get that out tonight, which is Friday. A little bit of viewing for you guys. And then hopefully be able to crack on with the shed tomorrow. And then hopefully get this uploaded Saturday night, maybe Sunday night, depending on how things turn out. Hope you've enjoyed this type of video. Obviously, it's a bit different. It's not just the sales or the pickups. It's a bit of both. It's everything in between. If you've enjoyed this video and, you know, you want to see a little bit more like this, days in the life kind of thing, I've just sold an item off of sold. Sims 3 Pets. That's quite good because I just picked up some Sims. £15.99 for that one. Happy days. But yeah, if you've enjoyed the video, you want to see more days in the life, hit like, leave a comment down below saying, yeah, but you know, I did like this instead of just the sales or a haul. A little bit different, mixes things up a little bit. But yeah, I've been John Luke, the Reselling White Boy. Appreciate you all. 500 subs now. How amazing is that? I'll see you next time.